Hello, hello, hi, how are you?
Good morning. Hi, how are you? I really want to welcome you for Wisdom Meets Bay. It's good to see you. A lot of people got a haircut, that's good. Jerry and then Eric, that's good. We are doing Revelations this semester, right? The Revelation is the last book of the Bible, right? So I'm pretty sure you are very familiar with this book. And we'll cover big chunk from chapter 5 to 8. So we are going fast, okay? Right? So, and this is very exciting because this book has been studied for 2,000 years. And then we have, many people have many different ideas, right? But when we read, I want to make sure just one thing, okay? And okay, so can I give you some tip on how to study, okay? Right? All right, so this is my friend Paul Timlin's way, okay? He went through the University of Illinois, and he never read any books, okay? And he graduated with all A's, okay? Almost all A's.
That's not true.
Almost all A's, okay? But he told me, okay, he got almost all A's, okay? And he's handsome, and he's intelligent, and he told me one day, hey, Sam, you know, I didn't buy any book. I just go to bookstore and look at it, and every time teacher assigns a book, and I read the first sentence and last sentence, that's it. And in the middle, I just listen to the professor very carefully, okay? And then when you read the Revelation, right, it says what? It says the revelation of what?
Jesus
Christ. So, this is our prayer. So when we read the Bible, what we are going to get? What's that? What, Harry?
Salvation.
Yeah, that's right. But salvation comes from Jesus Christ. Okay? So basically, when we are here, we are here to get Jesus Christ. Okay? Revelation of Jesus Christ. So a revelation is to meant to be revealed Jesus Christ. That's my number one assumption. Okay? Right? And then you just flip through the last page. Okay? And then the last verse. Okay? Chapter 22 is he who testifies to these things says, surely I'm coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The grace of our Jesus Christ be with you us all. Amen. Okay. So, we Christians believe that the history has three parts, okay? The God created heaven and earth. We believe that God made heaven and earth. And then, if you look at the Genesis chapter 3, then we sinned. And then, that the sin is a real problem. And Jesus has to come, redeem us, and then he died and rose from the dead. He went up to heaven, and he's coming back. That is the story. But how it's going to happen is very difficult, okay? Right? So there are many theories about how the world began, right? So we study physics, chemistry, and the biology to understand how things are happen. And then how things will end, right? So I have no idea, but we know the major things, okay? Jesus died for our sins, so Revelation starts with like this, okay? So one of the verses I really like is chapter 1, verse 5. We're going to jump around. It says, to him who loves us and who freed us from our sins by his blood, and made us a kingdom, priest to his God, and the Father, to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. So Revelation says, Jesus loves us. And that is our fundamental that we know as Christians, that Jesus loves us. And how he loves us is that he freed us from our sins by his blood. And next thing he did was, He gave salvation, but he gave us, he made us kingdom. Right? And we are priests. So we have a diverse group, okay? We have a diverse group, okay? If you look at it, we are very diverse, okay? I was born in Korea. Nikhil was born in India. Right? But person was born what?
Here.
Chicago, okay? Chicago is another country, okay? And and then, you know, Indonesia, China, you know, Taiwan, you know, we are all different, right? But we are kingdom. So we are made of Christ. So it's, we are very superficially different, but at the core, as Christians, we are kingdom, and God made us priests to glorify God, right? And it happened because Jesus loves us. That is our fundamental confession. So we confess every day, you know, Jesus loves us and made us a kingdom and gives us identity, okay? So our identity comes from, not from your nationality, right? Of course, Evan is from Ghana, okay? Right? So it's one of the most beautiful countries in Africa. And then, but he and I are connected. By what? We are in the same kingdom, and King is Jesus. Right? So that's a very important concept to understand. And then we look at the, and then this revelation is written to a church, seven churches, right? Seven churches, and now the seven churches are in Turkey nowadays. And then John says in verse chapter 1, verse 9, I, John, your brother and partner in the tribulation and the kingdom and the patient endurance there in Jesus, was on the island called Patmos on account of the word of God and testimony of Jesus Christ. So John was in an island and God revealed what's going to happen. Right? And he says, he doesn't say exactly what kind of tribulations, but he had some hard time. And then he was in the kingdom of God, and then God gave him the endurance to finish, you know. It's about the, John is about to die, and then God gave him this revelation. So I believe that God wants him to give him the encouragement. The Bible gives you encouragement. Practically, Bible is there to help you to endure and finish the race, and then we want to see Jesus, okay? Just coming. So, with that in mind, we're going to do chapters 5 and 8, and I'll teach you another technique of the study, okay? Right, let's pray. Heavenly Father, please open our eyes and help us to read Revelation and learn of Jesus, and teach us how to read Revelation and know who Jesus is and who we are before God. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
All right, so another tip, okay, another study tip. Okay, this is my way of, I talk about Paul Timmons' way, and I'll teach you how I read the Bible, okay? And I skim through the Bible, and I read, and then I go for the keywords, okay? Right? What is the keywords in the most important words you think? Okay, Jesus, okay. So when I hit Jesus, I'll slow down, okay? And but another one is therefore, okay? Therefore, right? So Eric knows that, okay? So therefore, then that tells you about what's the point, okay? Right? So therefore happens in chapter 7, verse 15. So I'm going to ask someone to read, therefore, okay? Who wants to read chapter 7, 15 through 17? How about Mr. Person? Could you read us? It's very important, okay, this therefore, so don't miss the point, okay? Okay. All right, so he's going to read this. Okay, read it carefully. Okay, ready.
Therefore they are before the throne of God, a certain day out of his temple, and he who sits on the throne will shelter them with his presence, They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more. The sun shall not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb in the midst of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of living water. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes.
I think when we live in this world, there are two things you can avoid. Number one is we have to work under the sun, okay? Toil, okay? And number two is that we cry. There's a deep sorrow. Why there are deep sorrows in this world? Because I believe that we can be easily misunderstood, and justice can be perverted, right? And there is some deep sense of why there are some sufferings in this world. Okay? So if you think about, you look around this world, and then you can see very easily, right? And then how do you process this kind of things, no? Right? It doesn't really matter how good you are, okay? For example, one example I can give you is that you can follow, you know, how many people drive here? Drive? Who has a license? Okay, everybody drive, okay. I don't care how well you drive, okay? You can start at the stop sign, you can be nice to people, okay? Yield, you know, you can tell them to move, okay? But the problem is that some people can come and hit you, okay? Right? Because some people can be careless. So, in order to this world to work well, means that everyone should behave and everyone should work together. Right? You understand? That's a very important concept. But because the Bible says we are sinners and we have self-interest and we can be somewhat selfish, and then we try to cut corners, and then we can be hit by all kinds of sufferings and disasters, right? And then, how do you process that? And so John saw something very strange, you know, in chapter 5, he saw somebody who had a scroll and the seven seals, okay? And then, you know, he wanted to read it, but no one can read it. But John says, only person who can read the scroll and open it is Jesus, the Lamb. So, think about it. The Bible tells Jesus as a Lamb, okay? The image of Jesus is important, okay? We know that he was righteous, who never sinned, but what happened to him? He was killed. Because he preached the justice of God and kingdom of God, and then people didn't like him and he killed him. Right? So it happens to the best of the person, okay? To Jesus. So as a Christians, God opened the scroll, and then there are seven seals, and opened them one by one. And all kind of disaster was happening. So what are you going to do when we see this world and all kinds of things are happening? Right? So God gave him this vision to John to have perseverance and endurance and encourage him to stand firm. So this is very encouraging word of God from Jesus. And also he saw a lot, you know, if you look at the fifth seal in chapter 5, when he opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar the souls of those who have been slain for the word of God and for the witness they had borne. They cried out with a loud voice, O sovereign Lord, holy and true, how long before you will judge the judge and avenge on those who dwell on the earth. They all each give a white robe and told them to rest a little. So, as a Christians, we cry out to God because we feel like that we are mistreated, and there are people who are slain because they confess Jesus. Okay? And how we can process this kind of injustice and then unfairness, okay? So I always talk to my son Peter, and we had a very heavy discussion. Is life fair or not fair? And then Peter always says, life is not fair, right? So, and he always go to mom and then, and, you know, hug mom because he don't say, oh, life is not fair because I love mom more than you, okay? And then that's true, okay? Life is not fair. Sometimes we feel like life is not fair. But God fair, Jesus fair, Jesus just, or not just? And what is he going to do with all the injustice done on this world? So Revelation revealed Jesus. Even though he was righteous, and in Revelation, if you look at Jesus, he comes in the very awesome images, like a lion and then double-edged sword and very strong, okay? There's a strong part of Jesus. But at the core of Jesus is the Lamb, who freed us from our sins by his blood, who did not open his mouth, and who loved us and gave us new life. And he died, but he rose from the dead. So this is the image of Jesus that we really want to look at, okay? And then we say, oh, Jesus is like a loser, no? But he's not. So when we read the Revelation, there are many things that we should see. But we have to see our Lord Jesus Christ. So I will go to the conclusion, okay? So, you know, and it ends with a very beautiful passage, okay? And then if you look at the chapter 7, and after this, I looked, okay? And in chapter 7, 9, and behold, a great multitude that no one could number, from every nation, from all tribes, and people, and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed in white robes, and palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, salvation belongs to God, who sits on the throne, and to the Lamb. So, when you look at the world, it seems like church is losing power. So if you go to England, the church attendance is like 2% every Sunday, and it seems like nothing's happening. But God showed him John the vision. And then, you know, in this chapter 7, first part, there are many people from the Jewish nation who are saved. And then, not only that, from other nations, from every tribe, too many to count. Right? How many can you count? What's the biggest number you count from 1 to 0, 1 to starting? Okay. I think people will give up about 50,000, okay? And one time I counted from 0 to 50,000, and it took me like 6 months, okay? That's about it. And then, you know, if you count up to million or billion, and nobody can count. So I was wondering, what's the longest, biggest number people count? How about Nikhil? What's the biggest number you have counted? What? 100. 100, okay, 100. Okay, that's about it. So we start counting, okay? And then nobody can count it. And this is the picture that I really want you to look at. God will unite every nation from every people to him. And then we can say salvation belongs to our God. And we are thankful because God loves us and frees us by his blood becoming a lamb, and he made us kingdom. So, I think in this country, the racism is real, okay? And different races don't get along, you know? And then we don't like each other, but when we become a kingdom, we have a king, and then we become brothers and sisters. So, John clearly identifies himself as brother and the partner in Jesus, okay? So I think it's very important to see it, because in my life I experienced somebody who was not my brother became my brother. And when I was in deep need, he came to me so generously and offered me help. And I was moved and said, why help me? Because Sam, you are my brother. So I had nothing to say, okay? Because he deeply believed in Jesus, and he wanted to share the love of Jesus. So, can we have this perspective? That God wants to save everyone, and God wants to bring everybody to his throne, and God wants, you know, to unite the whole world, which is Jesus, because he is the one who loves us, shed his blood, made us kingdom, and made us our priests. Right? And that is the things that we should look at. Right? So, and this is the way you can unite this the whole world. And God already showed John that he will accomplish this. Whenever God says, I will do it, and he will do it. So let's read chapter 7, 18, 15. Therefore, okay? So, all right, so when you read a book today, any kind of book, where are you going to stop? What are the words that you want to stop at, okay? You said, you see, every time you say therefore, can you stop, okay? Right? Anyway, you should ask Eric, okay? He did a good job in the MCAT, so. And he knows how to read, okay? And I'm pretty sure that whatever he says, therefore, he'll stop and think about it, okay? Right? Okay? Yeah, okay, that's true. So it's a proven method, okay? Therefore, very important word, okay? In the Bible. Therefore, as a conclusion, they are before the throne of God and serve him day and night, in the temple, and he who sits on the throne will shelter them with his presence. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst anymore. The sun shall not strike them, not any scorching heat. For the Lamb in the middle of the throne will be their shepherd. Okay, so here, the Lamb and the shepherd, I put them together, right? Because lamb cannot be a shepherd, but the characteristic of God is the lamb, okay, who was slain, and the shepherd who takes care of the lamb. Okay, so that is our Lord Jesus Christ. Because if you look at the Luke's Gospel, chapter 11, there is a big picture that that there was a one shepherd who had 100 lambs. And one got lost. Do you know what he did? He went out for this lost one. And then he searched and searched and found this one. And then he put, and after he found it, then what he did? He did not kick this lamb and say, oh, you're stupid, you were lost. Okay. No, he put up the lamb on his shoulder and carried it. Okay, so we have this romantic idea of lamb, okay? So cute, okay? You know how big that is? 300 pounds, big, you know? Right? And then he carried all the way and joyfully. And this is our shepherd. And our shepherd laid down our life, his life for us. And this is shepherd. The lamb and shepherd are connected together. He cares for us. And he loves us, and he wants to care for us. even we go to the kingdom of God, okay? So, I had a conversation with my mother. And mother is a mother, okay? Mother is a mother, no matter how old you are, okay? And I'm almost 50 years old, but she told me to, one time, get up early and then brush your teeth. Oh, mom, I don't want to do that. Why? Why you told me in front of my children, okay? Okay, so if you go to the kingdom of God, okay, then what Jesus will tell you, okay? Right? He said, I am your lamb, I am your shepherd, I lay down your life for you, and I'll serve you, and I'll make you breakfast. It's Jesus. So his character will not change, right? He who loves us and freed us from our sins by his blood, and his character will not change, and he will protect us, even in the kingdom of God. And he will lead us to where? God will wipe away every tear from our eyes, and then he will guide to the springs of living water. So people say, hey, if you go to the kingdom of God, what we will do? It's kind of boring, okay? You know? But we will ponder the love of Christ. And we'll ponder, and then we'll live under the protection of our Lord Jesus Christ. Right? That is our great picture. So can you see? So I talked about a few things about how to read, okay? And this is kind of difficult book to read because there are so many strange, weird pictures coming up. But John made it very clear. So he gave us enough clues where to stop, okay? Like when you talk about Jesus, we stop, okay? And describe what Jesus, we stop and look at it. And then, you know, if you want to make a point, then you say, therefore, okay? And you, okay, that's conclusion, okay? I'm not going to burden you because you are busy, but there is joy of reading the Bible, okay? And that there is joy of looking at Jesus. So I want to have this joy. Personally, you know, I studied chemistry, and then, you know, I think I did fairly well because I'm married and my wife is wonderful. And after that, I have a honeymoon baby, and then very good. And then I went to the best school to study chemistry. And somehow, you know, things did not work out well because, you know, I wrote the, I did the experiments, and then somebody stole my ideas and forced early, you know. I'm so upset, okay? And then I was so upset and said, oh, there's no injustice in this world, and I'll quit, okay? And but one person sent me a book, and he dedicated the book to me, and then studied the chemistry of Bible. And then after that, he gave me much more encouragement to do it, right? So Jesus says to us, I know your tribulations. I know your sufferings. And I know what you're going through. But I'll give you encouragement. Look at me, who died and rose from the dead. And look at me, I'll fix this world. And I will bring the justice. And I will become your shepherd forever. You know, live under my protection. And that is the Jesus is saying, right? So when we hear this kind of message, we are moved. And we want to know more about Jesus, okay? So I'll give you incentive to, a motivation to read and learn about Jesus, okay? And then that's our job. And then how we can practice it among us who are forgiven by Jesus and who are become a one nation, okay? And how we can work together and how we can love each other. And that is our homework, okay? So let's ponder the deep love of Christ and know about Jesus, and we thank God because he loved us, and okay, he loves us, okay, he's a continuous, he loves us, and who